Many of you may know Kevin McKrell, the musician from the McKrells. But did you know that he's also an oil painter? And he's pretty good at it too. We're here in Saratoga Springs to look at the oil paintings of Kevin McKrell. Follow me.
Dublin town, Dublin town. Lights come up, the sun goes down, and the shadows dance around and round with the lights of Dublin town.
Donnybrook Fair, the McKrells, played Carnegie Hall, Lincoln Center. I think that's where people basically know me from, is doing gigs like that. I've always been able to draw. It's just one of the things that I did, but I didn't really pay any attention to it. But in my 30s, I got asthma. Pretty bad. Well, I also smoked 3 packs a day. And touring and everything, my lungs just went, okay, you can't do this anymore, and gave up on me for a while. And while I was recouping, I started using the Christmas presents that people had been buying me for years that were stacked up in the closet. And the town of Boston Spa, had an art show that you could go and put your stuff out. And I went and I sold everything. Of course, I didn't know that you should charge more than 10 bucks for them, but they still sold. People bought them. And it just kept going from there. Faces. Mostly old guys with hats. My preference would be to just fill the entire canvas with face. I mean, it's in the eyes, really, I suppose. And I can't do a landscape to save my life. I have tried and I've tried. And it just, I will do a landscape and then freak out and put a big face in the middle of the landscape. I like to think of a painting almost like when I'm writing a song, a story. A story develops. What I'd like to do is look at my paintings as if they're just a moment. And I want people to think of what happened before and what happened after. So I'll get the photo, a photo I took in Ireland, or a picture I copped off the internet. It's just an interesting face. And I will, this is part of the thing that I didn't learn in school, is how to get the likeness, an exact likeness on the canvas. There's a grid thing that people do, and I just dive in. I'll cover the painting with one color, and I'll have at it with a rag, which is a constant companion. Sort of block in some basic shapes, and then I dive in. And unless I'm doing a job of a portrait of someone, which I do, and I'm not real fond of, but it you kind of have to, I just am free with it. Like there's a fellow I'm doing now, his mouth wasn't the way it was, but I'm looking at the face and going, wow, if I crinkle up his face and do it like that, he's gonna look like something's going on. Like these two, like and to me, the two boys in that painting there are having a little private joke. I've seen it in Irish bars 1,000 times where a tourist walks in or somebody walks in and the two fellas at the bar will start making fun of them to themselves. Like, oh, look at this one, hey. Like guys in bars all over the world, I guess.
Yeah.
I will paint away at it until, I know this is a little weird, but until they talk to me. When they talk to me, I'm done. And not until. March 17th of last year, we did a show at Cafe Lena. And I had the best year I've had in a very long time coming up. I had gigs, theater gigs. I had two gigs at the Egg coming up. Probably the best year I've had since doing Carnegie Hall, Lincoln Center with the old McKrells. And then everything in the space of a week went down. Everything stopped. So my way of making a living became non-existent. It didn't become, okay, you might not be able to do that. I don't know when performances are going to come back. some people say we can do outdoor performances, but which I do, a lot of festivals and stuff, but is that really viable? Thank God for painting, because I have been able to, you know, I sell prints on a website, so that works. I love being able to get up in the morning, paint until like 2 a.m, sleep, get up and do it again, over and over again. It's a joy. Not really good for any kind of social thing, but I'm okay with that. But to be able to perform again, to be able to go out in front of an audience again, would be absolutely wonderful. I miss it incredibly. I mean, you look at try to go glass half full, half empty, that I get to spend this much time on my artwork is great. But I'd rather be performing.